In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to add and use Hydra Music Bot in your Discord server. Start by heading to the Hydra Bot website. We will include a link in the description. Click Invite. A menu will appear. Expand the drop menu and select the server you want to add Hydra Bot to. Click Continue. Next, you will be asked to set the permissions for Hydra Bot. You can adjust these as you would like. However, they can interfere with some of the bot's functions. Removing the administrator permission should be fine. However, I'll be leaving it enabled. Authorize to confirm your settings. Verify that you're human and you will be redirected to the Hydra Bot dashboard. This means Hydra Bot has been added to your Discord server. At the top of the page, you will notice a prefix box. The prefix is the starting character for the command. By default, the prefix is set to a dot. We recommend leaving it, however, you can change it if you'd like. Keep in mind that if you change your prefix, you will need to use that in place of the dot for all commands we mention. You can also change the language used in your server using the drop menu on the right. Be sure to save any changes. Switch to Discord and open the server that you added Hydra Bot to. Select a text channel and type .setup. If you change the prefix, then you will need to use that in place of the dot. Send the message and a new channel will be created for song requests. This is the only channel that Hydra Bot will respond in, preventing members from using other text channels to play music. Switch to the new channel. If you'd like, you can rename the channel. Right-click and choose Edit Channel. Select the top box and change the channel name. Save changes. For your server members to be able to use the channel, you will need to adjust some channel permissions. Switch to the Permissions tab. Expand the Advanced Permissions. Select the Everyone role if it isn't already. Enable the ability to send messages and read message history. If your server doesn't have a general member role that is given to everyone, then you will also need to enable the View Channel permission. You may also want to disable some other permissions. We recommend disabling the ability to make public and private threads. Save changes. Click the plus icon to add another role. Choose your member's role. This is the role given to all server members. Enable the View Channel permission. This will preserve any verification system that you have set up in your server. Save changes, then close. To play a song with Hydra Bot, you will need to join a voice channel. Now, go to the song request channel that we set up and type .play, then the song title and artist name. You can also use .p followed by the song name and title. Send the message and Hydra Bot will join your voice channel and begin playing your selected song. The volume can be changed by right-clicking on Hydra in the voice channel and dragging the user volume up or down. The music can be controlled using commands or the reactions in the song requests channel. These controls are only available to admins and DJs. From left to right, the functions of the reactions are play and pause, stop, next track, loop, shuffle, favorite, unfavorite. The loop button has three modes. Clicking it once will loop the entire queue. A second click will loop the current song. A third click will disable the loop. Next, we will be setting up a DJ role for Hydra Bot. Anyone with a DJ role will have special permissions and control over the music, allowing them to loop songs, remove Hydra from a voice channel, shuffle songs, and more. Click on the server title. Open server settings. Switch to the Roles tab. Choose to create role. Select the top box and give the role a name. The name of the role can be anything that you want. I'll be calling mine DJ for simplicity. Give your role a color. Switch to the Permissions tab. Clear permissions. This will ensure that anybody that receives the DJ role doesn't have control over the server. Move to the side and drag the role into the position you want it. If you want the color selected to show for users with the DJ role, then ensure it is higher up the list. Save changes. Select the Hydra Bot role and move it up so it's above the member's role. Save changes and close. Head back to the Hydra Bot dashboard and refresh the page. Locate the DJ role section and click the plus icon. Select your newly created role from the list. If you don't see the role, then wait a few minutes and refresh again. Save. If you want to delete a DJ role, you can hover over it and click the cross. DJ roles can also be set up from inside Discord. Select a text channel and type .setDJ followed by a space and then the role name. Send the message and your DJ role will be created. Sending the same command again will remove the role as a DJ. Alternatively, you can remove all DJ roles by typing .setDJ space reset. Once the command is set, all DJ roles will be removed. Hydrabot can also be set to only work in specified voice channels. Start by creating the voice channels that you want Hydrabot to have access to. I have already created some. If you are creating a music room, then you may want to disable the permission to speak. Hover over the voice channel and click the gear icon. Switch to permissions. Expand the advanced settings if it isn't already. Make sure the everyone role is selected. Disable the ability to speak. Save changes and close. Switch to the Hydra dashboard. Refresh the page. On the right, you will see the voice channels heading. Select the drop menu and check the voice channels you want Hydra to be restricted to. Save. On the Hydrabot dashboard, we also have the ability to adjust non-DJ permissions. These can only be adjusted if a DJ role is active. These options are primarily used to prevent spam and trolling. On the left, you can set the maximum length of a song that can be submitted by someone that isn't a DJ. Select the box and set the length as you like. On the right, you can choose the maximum amount of songs that can be added to the queue by a non-DJ. We recommend keeping this fairly low to prevent spam. At the bottom of the Hydrabot dashboard, you have configuration settings and announcement settings. Under each setting, there is a description of what the feature does. These can be set up as you like. We recommend turning on the Delete Song Announcements option to keep the channel clean. Click Save to confirm your settings. There is an extensive number of Hydrabot commands available, so we'll quickly cover the more useful ones with an example shown on screen. Some commands also have an alias, which is an alternative command. Everyone commands can be used by anyone in the server that can send messages in the requests channel. .play followed by a space and song title and artist will play a song. .voteSkip will vote to skip the song that is currently playing. Users with the DJ role have access to even more useful commands. .pause will pause the song. .resume will resume playing the song when it has been paused. .skip will skip the current song. .stop will stop the music altogether and clear all songs that have been queued. .shuffle will shuffle the queued songs in a random order. .leave will disconnect Hydrabot from the channel. Finally, there are admin commands. Admins can also use all of the DJ commands. .ban will allow you to ban a user from requesting songs. .unban will allow you to unban a user. A link will be provided in the description to the Hydrabot commands page. Hydra Music Bot will now be added and set up in your Discord server.